MedCram.com.
Welcome to another MedCram lecture and BoardVitals question. This one comes from the Internal Medicine and Pathology question banks. Here's the question. In a move that could increase the nation's blood supply by at least 4% a year, the FDA has recommended an end to a lifetime ban on blood donations for gay men. The FDA issued draft guidance in 2015 regarding the acceptance of men who have sex with men, or MSM, to donate blood. The window for HIV-NAT, which is nucleic acid testing, is approximately 9 days. And the incidence of HIV in the MSM population is about 1% per year. In other words, that's 1 per 100 persons in 1 year. Based on this information, what is the likelihood that an MSM individual would be within the window to be able to transmit HIV via blood components? And we have our answer choices down below here. We've got A is 1 in 1.5 million, 1 in 4,055, which is the correct answer, 1 in 357,000, 1 in 100,000, or 1 in 507. So let's take a look at this and see what the right answer is and why that's the right answer. So the thing that you've got to realize is that when someone gets HIV infection, there was a period of time of about 22 days until antibodies would show up. And then, of course, you've got antibodies from that point on. And then it's pretty easy to be able to tell whether the donated blood has HIV in it. That's a no-brainer, that's no problem. The problem was is that if you checked for antibodies within 22 days of the person getting an HIV infection, you would not detect it and you would not know whether or not this blood was tainted with the HIV virus. Well, go ahead now and enter in something called NAT. Well, NAT actually looks for something different than antibodies. Remember, antibodies are the body's response to the virus. So instead of looking for antibodies, we did something called nucleic acid testing. And that brought it all the way down to 9 days. What this did was it shortened the window period. So in other words, now we could do nucleic acid testing on blood and it would be able to detect far more infections, but we're still left with this 9-day period of time after an infection, whenever it happens, that you will not be able to tell whether or not this blood is tainted with the HIV virus. So the question is really, what are the chances that if you use NAT testing, that you're going to spread HIV into the population because we cannot detect it? Again, what we're looking at here in the question is specifically that the window period, as we talked about, is 9 days. That's 9 days out of 365 days. The question is what is the chances of somebody having HIV during the 9-day window period? Well, that's very simple. It's simply the chances or the probability of having HIV times the probability of being during the window period. And so what is that? Well, the chances of having HIV, as they said, in the MSM population is going to be 1 over 100. Multiply that by being in the window period, and that's simply going to be 9 divided by 365. This equals 9 divided by 365. 0, 0, which equals, you guessed it, 1 over 4055. I hope that answers your question. Thanks for joining us.